there pick up? It's me, your brother. Oh, I was hoping you were going to be in. I needed you to be in. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking you only have phones when there's something wrong. Well, something is wrong. Very wrong. I'm still in Dorset. I'm not the only one here. There's two students from Weymouth University. Polly and Nigel. Ghost hunters, would you believe? Well, I didn't believe. I do now. I need you to leave now. I need you to come here. I would go to the police, but... well, they'd laugh in my face. Ghost hunters. I think whatever they were hunting's found them. I think it's found me, too. Please help. You're always good with things like this. If you leave now, you can catch the late train from Paddington to Weymouth. From Weymouth, get a cab. Come to Dowerton Station. It's abandoned. I'll be waiting. I really need your help on this. The sooner you can get here, the better. This place is really beginning to freak me out. I tried to find Polly or Nigel earlier and I couldn't find them anywhere. They wouldn't just leave. This all started a few days ago. It was when... I can hear it. I can hear it. It's right outside the door. Whispering. It's whispering my name. It knows my name. I've got to open the door. I've got to open the door.
Oh, good. You're awake. We're in the tunnel. The train tunnel. Just in case you were wondering where we are. Why don't you have a look around? But don't go too far. Not just yet. I have a lot to tell you. You're from London, ain't you? We came from London a couple of years ago in 41. Doctor said we had to. Air was bad for me and me dad. Breathing problems or something. Hey, let's keep moving, shall we? I can see the others too. So maybe I can help you. I think the others are hoping you'll be able to help them. One of them knows you. Your brother, ain't it? He's the new one. Only just arrived. He feels a bit confused. I was like that at first, but you get used to it. I'm Tim, by the way. Timothy Pike. I normally play it, or on the footbridge. I like to watch the trains. But there ain't no trains. Not now. But listen, don't tell me Dad that I'm in here. He'd kill me, if you know what I mean. Anyway, let's get you out of this tunnel. We'll catch your death. See? We're near the station now. It won't always like this. It's bright and busy and full of people. I think they must have shut it down. I don't remember why. I don't remember much at all. Not even the way home. But perhaps you can help me with that. Climb up on the platform. To your right now. Go on. I mean, you don't want to go down there till you got some light. That's your mate in this place. It hides in the dark, you see. You'll see what I mean later. That's it. That's where you can get started. Open the door. There's a switch in front of you. Pull it. It's time this place had a bit more light, don't you think? It's time. When you've finished in here, I'll be outside. I can still help you if you get stuck. You can find me on the wooden footbridge. I play there a lot. It's sort of, well, safe. Cause it's secret, you see. It don't know I'm here, talking to you. But it will soon, so I'd better go. Remember, I'll be on the footbridge. I'll leave you a note. Bye for now.
Thank you. you are there. My name is Nigel. Nigel Danvers. Me and my colleague Polly, we were working in the hotel. You'll find out more about that later. But listen to me for now, because I haven't got much time. It probably knows I'm talking to you, so I'll have to be quick. You have to get into our room. We're doing some work in the hotel. You'll find out what later. For now, all you need to know is you need to find the key. You should find it. I have great faith in you. The key, I left it in a teapot. Yes, in a teapot. Don't remember where. Silver teapot. I'm sure you'll find it. I must go now, it's here. I've got to go.
Ah? Paper costs money, Betty, so don't waste it. Stop doodling and drawing on it.
Are you there? Who are you? What do you want? I'd leave this place if I were you, if you know what's good for you. This room is ghastly. Why did I ever come here?
You're very nosy, aren't you? Poking around in other people's things. What a strange clock. It's got buttons on it.
Are you interested in astronomy too? Edith is a wonder. She's been the perfect host for several years now. Strange taste in art, though. That's one of the constellations. Looks familiar. Brighter than the rest. I don't recognize it at all. too sure why George gave me this. It was a bag of nerves at the time. It's written on vellum, you know. Do you know what that is? It's skin. Animal skin, we can hope.
Fife Ness, west by north, 3, 9.
Are you the one carrying on George's work? If so, you should know that there are 12 of those weird symbols. I had one, Betty had one, the guests had one each too. Not all of them remain anymore. Lost, destroyed, or taken. It knows what you're doing, you'll have to be careful. My symbol is in my room. You'll find it. If you have a song in your heart, can you sing? I love a good song. Frank loved a good song too. Bless him. I'm going now. The others are waiting. They're waiting for you too. Listen, love, don't join them. It already has your brother. Pete, isn't it? Sad it is. So young, it's not right. It's listening now to everything I tell you. You'd better be careful.
Thank you.
terrible is happening in this hotel. Nigel has gone. I don't know where. He was behind me and then, well, he's gone. Read my journal, if you haven't already. We should never have come here. We were not prepared. We discovered something using the thermoscanner. I've written the settings in a safe place. Upstairs, in the bathroom, find them. We have sealed the chamber back up, but it's only temporary. If you find the settings, you may gain access and perhaps find Nigel. Please, God, let him be all right. I cannot connect either online or by phone. I'll have to venture beyond this room. I think it's gone. It was outside the door. Now is the time to make a move. Wish me luck.
Thank you. Dragon Inn. The best takeaway Chinese food this side of Dorchester. This is an automated service. Please hold the line while we check your number. You have a standing order with us. Would you like us to deliver your usual order? Please press the star key twice for yes, or press 1 to make a new order. Your usual order is number 15. You have now ordered number 15. Sorry, but the shop is closed. We close at 11.
And that program is repeated on Saturday at 2:15 p.m. With the time 11:30 GMT, we join Stephen Ashurst for a new series of This Working Life. Good morning, and welcome to This Working Life with me, Stephen Ashurst. Each episode will be focusing on individuals who have chosen interesting and sometimes strange careers for themselves. This week we interview Polly White, a self-confessed ghost hunter, and Joanne Coles, a promoter of traditional Yorkshire puddings. And finally, Philip Luzek, an organic bird food farmer from Brittany. Okay, firstly, Polly, good morning. Why such an odd profession?
Well, firstly, I don't like to think of it as odd. Really, it is such like another science, sadly a rather ignored or ridiculed one. The routines, practices, recording and experiments follow the same rules and criteria. I like to refer to it as an alternative science, rather like you have alternative religions and medicine.
When did you first become interested in, to coin your phrase, the alternative sciences?
Funnily enough, I was doing my foundation course at the time for a regular physics degree. I had a supernatural experience and became interested in the cause and reason.
Care to elaborate?
Of course. Well, I was at Sussex University at the time, and had been for 3 months. Some friends and I were talked into trying a Ouija board session. Naturally, I at first thought the idea ridiculous, but went along with the others, if only to scoff at them when nothing happened. But something did happen.
Care to elaborate?
A lengthy and sustained conversation with an intelligent spectral phenomenon. It quite shook me up at first, and then I became fascinated. Within a month, we had all dropped out of our courses and were seeking alternatives. Regular physics just didn't seem rewarding or exciting after that night.
You did find an alternative course. Would you like to talk about it?
Yes. I was reading a science fiction magazine and saw an advertisement for a new group of experimental courses at Weymouth University. They are the brainchild of Henry Cuttle, who actually lectures on everything from the supernatural to warp science theories. It was partly Henry's influence that got us the doubt and experiment.
This is your new project, yes?
Yes, sponsored by Haddon Industries. Myself and fellow student Nigel Danvers are spending the next couple of weeks, and possibly more, in the abandoned station and hotel just outside the village. Sadly, the buildings are about to undergo major redevelopment to convert them into a bar, club and restaurant. This is a pity, as the building is essentially a living museum. The owners, the Crabtree Estate, have kept the place as sealed as possible. They lost their son in 1947. He disappeared from the hotel.
Yes, I remember reading something about that. He disappeared, didn't he? Along with several others.
Yes, all on the same night. They were not the only ones either. As recent as the early 80s, people have been disappearing from around that area.
Do you believe they're connected?
It would be less realistic to think that they are not. It's too much of a coincidence.
The police don't agree with that theory, do they?
No, they still state that George Crabtree abducted the guests and staff after midnight and disposed of the bodies. This is, quite frankly, ridiculous. Where are the bodies? Where is George Crabtree? Did he dispose of himself as well?
What is your theory?
I haven't got one, yet. We are hoping the experiment will provide some clues.
How are you going about it?
Haddon Industries have lent us a wonderful array of gadgets and equipment, some experimental, others obvious, CCTV, microphones, and an operating system designed especially. We're very excited about it.
It does sound terribly exciting. Is there a possibility that you could return to tell us some of your results?
Certainly. I look forward to it.
Thank you. That sounds brilliant.
So, you found my little secret.
Good evening. Have not seen George about, have you? I'll have a bottle of wine while I wait. I have some fantastic news. I must share it with someone. Betty's playing well tonight. Marvellous. But it's paid off. I think we're in for quite a night, don't you think?
Exactly, do you want to see me? Your note was, how can I put it, quite cryptic, Miss Fly.
I'm not the only one who reads those filthy newspapers, you know. Someone else will notice.
Notice what?
Your little secret, my dear. You have been busy, haven't you? More wine?
I take it you want some sort of deal. A cut, as it were. And I would want a guarantee in return.
I knew we could work this out.
Pour away, Miss Fly.
Eat that you will, Thomas. Where have you been? It feels late. Too late, maybe. You better leave now.
Good evening.
Good
evening. Hello.
It's a combination.
Bet you're very well tonight.
You did it. I knew you could. I can go home now. Well, you know what I mean. My dad is dead and buried. Perhaps he'll be waiting for me. With my mum as well. You stopped the dark fall spreading. It's trapped again, where it belongs. You may as well leave too. There's nothing here for you now. Time you had a rest, I think. One last thing, though. Things don't have to turn out as they did. You'll find out what I mean soon. Bye.
Hello, it's me, your brother. I've got something important to tell you. Well, I'll have to tell you now. I've completely forgotten. Well, it can't have been that important after all. Oh, well, I'm going to be back in a couple of days anyway. The station and hotel redevelopment for the Crabtree Estate's gone, well, better than planned. No surprises. When I get back, I think I owe you a drink or two. Haven't seen you for a while. Been neglecting you. Okay, I'll see you when I get back. Bye.